trying to pee up. I'm trying to say the couldn't see us. If you want to be us, you just gotta believe us. That we about to shake the whole globe, so I don't write rhymes, I write checks. Might rewrite your life if the price set. Might check 1212. It's the Denzel coming out of the zoo. Carry city what I breed. Dissect the flow so you can see what I bleed. Put it all together.
All right, coming up next, it is our main event, a matchup for the UFC Women's Bantamweight title. Here she is, the former UFC Women's Bantamweight Champion, Holly Holm. It was Melbourne, Australia. It was UFC 193, November 15th of 2015, when Holly Holm effectively changed her life forever.
Holly Holm changed her life, but she changed the landscape of mixed martial arts.
Yes.
She showed that Ronda Rousey was not this unbeatable fighter that everybody thought she was to be. Went out there, set her trap with that lead left hand, used her footwork and movement to walk Rousey right into a beautiful head kick that finished the fight. A multiple time boxing champion, amateur kickboxing background, Holly Holm is just truly some professional.
And that Rousey win, still one of the biggest upsets, betting odds or otherwise, in UFC history. Well, I'm not sure if she's a third degree or a fourth degree Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu black belt. All I know is that you are in imminent danger every time she closes the distance.
Oh, the belt color hasn't changed, John, but they are just adding stripe after stripe after stripe. She's got so many stripes on her Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu black belt that it's unbelievable. And because of that ability to do Jiu-Jitsu at such a high level, it's almost like you're going into biology class whenever you go on the ground with her. Because as you're thinking, if I do step one to get to step two, she's already on step five.
Right.
She's working on the finish before you even understand that you're in danger. The quick strike ability in the jiu-jitsu is something not many people possess.
I cheated to pass my biology final in college. I wish there was a way to cheat in jiu-jitsu, but she doesn't need to. Big spot for her here tonight.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. And when the action begins, a referee in charge of the octagon, Eve Loving. And now, this is the moment UFC fans around the world have been waiting for. Live from the sold-out Prudential Center in Newark, New Jersey, it's time for the undisputed UFC Bantamweight Championship of the World. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This woman is a boxer, holding a professional record of 19 wins, 7 losses. She stands 5 feet 8 inches tall, weighing in at 135 pounds. Fighting out of Albuquerque, New Mexico, presenting the challenger, Holly the Preacher's Daughter, Holm. And now introducing the champion, fighting out of the red corner. This woman is a jiu-jitsu fighter, holding a professional record of 21 wins, no losses. She stands 5 feet 9 inches tall, weighing in at 135 pounds. Fighting out of the Republic of Dagestan, Russia, presenting the reigning, defending, undisputed UFC Women's Bantamweight Champion of the World, the Warrior.
UFC belt online, protect yourself at all time, obey my command at all time. If you want to touch love, do it now, go back to your corner.
They touch him up and we are underway. So round one is underway. After her last fight, you heard Bruce Buffer say, and still, UFC Women's Bantamweight Champion. She is trying to have him say it again here tonight. She is unquestionably the number one 135-pound fighter in the world. She has successfully defended this belt in the past, and she believes here tonight she's on a different level than the number one contender. We'll see if she can prove it here and turn those words into actions as round one gets underway. Man, her striking looks clean tonight. Timing on point.
Her timing's on point. Her accuracy's on point. She's very busy. She's in a good flow. Powerful leg kick lands.
Oh, and there's another leg kick just out, right? I mean, now she has sort of rendered her opponent, as you see the damage, a one-legged fighter.
She is fighting a one-legged fighter, a wounded gazelle, right in front of a hungry lion. That is not a great position to be. Nice.
Oh, huge right hand. Her ground and pound is on point here. She's made this a focus going in to make these strikes count. Certainly doing that tonight.
She's making each and every one of them count. Doing a very, very good job of landing shots, landing them in combination, and making them all matter. Nice kick.
And there's a takedown attempt. She's doubling up on the jab there. And there's a takedown attempt.
Big punch lands.
Back and forth we go here. She's over the top. She's wobbly now.
She's hurt very bad. She's on skates. She has to get moving. If she stays in front of her opponent, she's going to take one more that's going to end the night. Right beside control. Yep. Slip under the neck.
Oh, we're getting a finish here. And this might just be a matter of time. Wow.
And this is where she's good. Once she's on top is where she's a beast.
Well, she did not miss a single grappling crack. Going for the arm here.
The kimura is not the arm. It's the shoulder pressure that usually makes you tap.
Oh, we're getting a finish here. Round two next. Let's take a look back at some of the action from that previous round. DC Chief among it, the big knockdown courtesy of that punch.
A big knockdown off of that punch. She was flowing, letting everything go. And then she sat down on that strike that put her opponent down. It looked like the fight was over, but we do go forward.
Liver kick. All right, so she attempts the takedown here. Decent entry, but unable to get the fight to the ground.
She's having a difficult time securing the hips. Why not go upper body, try to engage in the clinch. Try to mix it up if you're going to get these takedowns.
What a strike by her there. I'd be knocked out. Her opponent's still standing.
She's still standing, but she's got to get on her bike, John. She's got to get out to the center of the octagon, find some space so that she can evade her opponent from finishing it. Big kick.
Trying to kick the leg out.
Way to hide that leg kick. Beautiful strike.
Mixes it up nicely in terms of staying heavy and also staying active. And they separate. Man, how good is her jab? And there it is again. So that
nice takedown. And that takedown was because she had to get that takedown.
Looks like she's trying to set up a sub here. Just be a matter of time.
Oh,
Transitioning to the arm submission now.
The Kimura is not the arm. It's the shoulder pressure that usually makes you tap.
Oh, we're getting a finish here. Well, there are a few things more fun to watch in mixed martial arts than these type of transitions and scrambles on the ground.
High-level grappling can really be entertaining.
Under a minute to go. Continues to apply pressure here in half guard. When you get in a bad spot on the ground and you want to reverse it, that's what you need to do.
Masterclass in changing positions.
Oh, she's going for a submission attempt now. Just in time, thought maybe she might tap there, but you know how tough she is, so the submission attempt right at the end of the round, saved by the bell, back to the stools they go. We'll see if she can recover in time for this next round.
Real close to getting those submissions. I love it. Now, I want you to...
All right, a lot of tremendous striking action in that last round, DC. I know you don't have a telestrator, but take us through the replay.
I mean, I would love to have my telestrator right now. That was a great display of high-level mixed martial arts striking. Both combatants stood toe-to-toe and let it all hang out.
All right, here we go with this third round of this championship fight.
Look at the turnover in that kick.
Oh, she's really starting to...
She is such a diverse striker that that big strike landed, and it looks like she's going to finish this fight.
Slip under the neck. Watch triangle, watch triangle.
Oh. That is tight.
Wow. She's got side control now. Maybe some of those knee strikes to the body. A lot of different things available to her here.
Now, in the side control, you may feel like the bottom person that you have a lot of outs, but there is a lot of danger in those positions. Oh, nice headlock. Oh!
Oh, we're getting a finish here. Here off of her back. Nice offense from the bottom. Oh, excellent pressure here from top position by Holm. Back to her feet now. Good sign for her there. Oh, beautiful job by her there as she gets the takedown.
You knew exactly what you were in store for. It was up to you to stop it, and you didn't get the job done.
Man, she is just nonstop on the ground, moving in all the right directions. Another nice transition by her there.
She's moving a lot, but every movement has purpose.
Going for a leg lock.
Oh!
Oh, we're getting a finish here. Great movement by her here on the ground, and she just does it.
Oh, nice. The Kimura is not the arm. It's the shoulder pressure that usually makes you tap.
Oh, saved by the bell. Round over. And the finish came just in time. Thought maybe she might tap there, but you know how tough she is. So the submission attempt right at the end of the round, saved by the bell. Back to the stools they go. We'll see if she can recover in time for this next round. I think we are the only two men sitting in this arena as we have arrived at round four and we enter the championship rounds. A huge, huge 5 minutes coming up for these two young men.
J.A., I couldn't have imagined that this fight would be this good. It's round number four now. Who can really keep fighting at such a high level with such good technical skills as they've gone into round number four?
Trying to set up a submission now.
Watch triangle.
There it is.
Getting tighter. Wow. All right, side control for her now. And you know how heavy she stays with all of that upper body strength. We'll see what she can do from here.
Well, she's got great upper body strength, and that's why she passes, because she doesn't necessarily...
Looks like she's trying to set up a submission now.
Now it's starting to slip under the neck.
Oh, we're getting a finish here.
Now she's in trouble.
Back to their feet here. Oh, she is absolutely getting lit up right now. She has certainly changed her... Oh! Well, she was long on grappling experience.
Oh, wow! Oh!
Now it's starting to slip under the neck.
Oh, we're getting a finish here. And this might just be a matter of time. Wow.
Now she's in full mount.
Final minute. Well, Holmes right back to the full mount. Going for a submission. Oh, we're getting a finish here. The sheer will is really remarkable to watch.
Oh, this is where you don't want to be, though.
All right, so a huge moment for her in that previous round, DC, as we show you some of the highlights. The knockdown nearly closed the show for her.
Yeah, and that's what we're going to focus on. We're going to focus on the knockdown because it looked like the fight was over. Now, is her opponent tough? Yes. But is her opponent smart enough to make the necessary adjustment as this fight goes forward?
Here we go, fifth and final round. Oh, she's been setting up that weapon all night. She did not miss there.
She's been looking for it, and she finally got it. And now she's going to see if she can close the night.
Oh, nice job by her to posture up there. Now we'll see if she can maintain that separation.
She has to recognize that her opponent will start trying to squirrel away now, but look for her big round.
Submission attempt for her now.
Watch triangle.
Oh.
deep. There you go.
She's right into side control right now, and a lot of fighters would prefer the half guard, but she does some pretty good work here.
She does good work in the side control. She likes it. A lot of people will not even pass the side control anymore because it seems like you're giving your opponent an out. But she loves the fact that she has such a great guillotine, and if they turn one way, she'll attack it. So you only have one option to escape this young lady, and by going to your knees, she
takes the back, now going for the rear naked choke. Oh, we're getting a finish here.
Look at that, it's tight.
And there it is!
Holy smokes! Woo!
Yeah, no doubt about it. That is some opportunistic grappling right there. And nice finishing instincts as well. You see a lot of fighters get the dominant position, but aren't necessarily able to lock up the choke or force the tap. No problem with her as she gets one of the bigger wins of her UFC career. So there she is as the celebration continues in the corner, the queen of the 135ers, the UFC Women's Bantamweight Champion, your winner tonight by way of submission. What a way to get the job done and leave with the UFC gold.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Eve Levine has called a stop to this contest at 2 minutes, 49 seconds of round number 5. Declaring the winner by tap out.
Israel Adesanya, she doesn't hope and pray. She aims and fires, and she is still the UFC Women's Bantamweight Champion.
What a great champion that rules atop this division. She's the queen of the world, in one of the UFC's best women's divisions.
Blew a bag on it, cause he know I'm worth it. Maybelline cover girl for certain. And my